Hello, this is Angela with Parker's Permaculture. I thought I would show you around little bits of the garden and the things that are beginning to ripen up this time of year. You can see this Italian prune plum here in my front yard, which is struggling with aphids a little bit this year. Normally doesn't have that problem, but it has still set loads of fruit. Grapes grow very quickly over the path this time of year, constantly pruning them back. You can see here these grapes are all ripe. I've been picking a hand every day. They'll get sweeter over the next few days, but loads and loads of grapes. I don't remember the name of these. I thought they were cannabis, and one of my viewers corrected me and said that they're not. I got them at the Home Orchard Society 12 years ago as a cutting, and I think they must have been mislabeled. They're delicious, but also very, very seedy. Probably could eat a hand every evening this time of year. These up here are a green variety that they're kind of green with. Let me pick a hand here. They're kind of green with a little bit of a pinky blush. Oh, hello, aunt. Green with a little bit of a pinky blush, and they are very sweet and ripe. Also with seeds, but not quite as large as seeds or as obtrusive. I can kind of eat the whole thing without spitting out the seeds. These, you need to spit out the seeds. You can see the comparison. Sometimes when you get heirloom varieties, it's a little bit of a mystery. So I'm gonna be not in the video at all because I have an autoimmune disease which is flaring quite badly right now, and my eye is not something that you wanna be looking at, and I do not wanna be on camera. So we're just gonna do the rest of this video off camera. You can see my Stanley plum is starting to turn. Not quite ripe yet. A few are getting close up in here, but they're still rock hard, so a little bit longer. A little bit longer here. These need a few more days. And these will ripen over, a couple of weeks. I'll have tons for freezing and for cooking and for drying. So this is just the front yard of my garden. Just the front yard. You can see the pawpaws, not ready yet, rock hard and still too small, but look how many there are. Pawpaws everywhere. Later in September, I'm gonna have quite a good crop. Let me see if I can lift this up so you can see underneath. Look at this one. I cannot even believe how many pawpaws this set off of one flower. Pawpaws can set, you usually think of between 1 and 5 fruits off of one flower, but this one has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Beautiful. Goji berry is looking a little bit sad this time of year, and that's because I didn't prune out the old wood. So I've been picking these. They're quite good in salad. I don't really love goji for fresh eating as a fruit. They tend to be not that much to write home about. So you can see there's a lot more on the vine than I'm going to be able to use, but I will feed the rest to the turkeys and have been. Had a little bit of wind, and so some of my blackberry canes have been knocked over. I'll need to pick those up. These are primo canes, so they will fruit next year. Other pawpaw, I'm not gonna go climb in here, but other pawpaw loaded with pawpaws as well. Gonna have some to share with friends soon. Hudson's Golden Gem apples are still too small. This is a later variety of apple. My youngest child, this is his favorite. It's a yellow, russeted, oblong apple, very buttery in flavor. Aronia berries here are ripening. Good for cooking and juicing and making jam. They are, let's see if my camera will cooperate here. Focus. My camera doesn't want to focus. So the aronia berries, you can see the comparison with them and the goji berries. Not good for fresh eating, but definitely good for cooking and preserving, making juice and jam. And someone said they use theirs to make a lot of vinegars. So I thought that was interesting. Have to try that. So this is my Nikita's Gift persimmon. I got it because I thought it was a great dwarf persimmon for the front yard. You can see here, there's a few persimmons up there, but this tree tends to abort about 80% of its persimmons every year. And I don't know if it's because it's still relatively young, but I'm getting frustrated with it. The persimmons it does produce are quite tasty. I tend to make cake and bread and things with them, but I can't continue to have this tree reject 80% of its fruit once it gets about 75% of the way to adult size. So every year, come early September, it drops tons and tons and tons of immature fruit, and I don't know how many more years I'm gonna be able to keep experimenting with it versus I'm gonna rip it out and maybe put in another variety that I know does much better. A lot of late August and early September is anticipation. You can see all of my quince here. Always a good year for quince. Without fail, they produce well for me. No matter what kind of a year I have, no matter what kind of other stressors they have, can see here, everything's a little stressed this year. Even so, my quince are gonna set tons for me. Volunteer pumpkin up here. Ooh. So I have gotten my, back up here, I've gotten my rambling rose here removed from the pergola and all pruned and tied into the arch. That takes about an hour of work and I really enjoy it, but I'm always full of injuries from the rose as a result. Stepping through here and stepping out into the garden, rain garden here. Kitchen that I can't seem to finish, but look, we have cleared off all of the wood we were storing in there now that we are getting our sheds all organized. Merit tree collards looking very nice. These are turning out to be a great tree collard. I really like them. You can see the shed here. We took out the post that was here. We put in a really sturdy king header, and now I'm waiting for the rain to come back, and I'm going to remove this rose and move it elsewhere. It's had bud blast. It's very prone to bud blast because every year, right as it is starting to flower, it rains, and this variety does not do well, so I'm probably going to take it out altogether. But now we can easily get wheelbarrows in, I can easily access poultry feed, much more usable shed. My Sun Gold cherry tomatoes, actually just did a blog post on tomatoes and trying to get your tomatoes to ripen. My Sun Gold cherry tomatoes are such a consistent, fantastic producer for me. If you could grow one kind of tomato in a cooler or shorter season climate, this is the one I would recommend 10 times out of 10. As I said in my last video, gonna be a good year for pepita pumpkins. The vine here is almost at the end of its life. You can see it's getting very tired looking. I saw someone post recently, this morning in fact, in a group, asking like, what do I do when I'm starting to get powdery mildew on my squash? What do I do when my squash is starting to look kind of tired? It's just getting to be that time of year that these are at the end of their life and they're naturally exhausted. You can see I've come through and removed, not so neatly, but I did, removed with a hori-hori actually, all of the blossoms off of my tomatoes. That's to try and accelerate ripening of the tomatoes that are quote unquote green mature. I'm trying to get them to turn color. I have a blog post all about this.
The fall gold raspberries are beginning to produce. Just starting. They always are a little bit late for me. You can see here. A great September crop in my garden. Overall, as it's starting to be the latter end of the gardening season, I have mixed feelings about this year. It was a really hard year. We had a really difficult spring where it was cold and we had a late snow past our last frost date. Very cold, wet, weird spring. Lots of fruit was really negatively impacted, and I've had weird disease pressure this year that I've not had in other years. So it's been a hard year in the garden in many respects. Some things producing exceptionally well, some things struggling. I feel like that's how it is every year. If we accept that there's going to be a mix
the mix every year. And we set those realistic expectations, then we're gonna feel more successful in the garden. I don't want perfection. My garden is not perfect. There are always problems. Always things outside my control.
I hope you enjoyed taking a little look around with me at a few of the things that are ripening in my garden, some of the things that are doing well, and some of the things that aren't this year. It's so important that we are honest with each other about how our gardens are doing. There's no reason to be performative in the way that we describe our gardens, because so much of gardening is out of our control. And so much of it is about letting go of control and accepting that not everything will be perfect every year. And that does not mean our gardens are not abundant, productive, and beneficial spaces for us. I'll be back later this week. I am going to probably have a few more videos off camera while I wait for this flare to kind of die down. But that doesn't mean I won't be turning out videos, because I have lots of stuff recorded that I need to edit. So thank you so much for watching today. Please click subscribe and please share with your friends. Thanks.